Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. In each tip video and post, I answer a question that I got from a viewer or reader. And here's the one that I want to answer today. I need to initialize the associations of multiple entities. Is there a way to tell Hibernate to fetch the associations for multiple entities in the same query? The best way to load associated entities is to use a join fetch clause or a named entity graph. These tell Hibernate to fetch the associated entities with the initial query. So Hibernate joins the mapped database tables and loads all the data with only one query. But if you can't use these options, or if the created Cartesian product gets too big, there's also another Hibernate-specific option. You can also annotate the association with Hibernate's batch size annotation. It tells Hibernate to initialize the relationship of multiple author entities in batches. That's not as efficient as a join fetch clause or an entity graph, but it's better than loading the associations one by one. Let's take a look at an example. Here you can see an author entity that has a many-to-many association to a book entity. I annotated it with the batch size annotation and set the size attribute to 5. That tells Hibernate to load the book's associations for up to 5 author entities in one query. Hibernate uses it when you load multiple author entities from the database, as I do in this test case. This query selects all author entities, and then I iterate over the list. Without the batch size annotation, Hibernate would perform a query for each call of the size method. So let's run this test and take a look at the log output. As you can see here, Hibernate executed one query to load the 6 author entities that exist in my test database. Then the test case starts to iterate through the list of author entities. When it uses the book's relationship of the first author entity, Hibernate initializes the association of the first 5 author entities returned by the previous query. As you can see in the log output, it uses an in clause to efficiently reference the primary keys of the 5 entities. And when the test case calls the getBooks method of the 6th and last author entity, Hibernate performs another query to fetch the associated book entities. That is a lot better than loading the associations one by one. But in most situations, it would be even better to initialize them with the query that loads the entity. JPA and Hibernate provide different options to do that. I show you 5 of them in my video 5 ways to initialize lazy associations and when to use them. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!